Everybody was into the war effort. The women who were left at home got jobs in factories making products for the war.
Or they rolled bandages for the Red Cross.
Or they were into, yeah. But everybody was active in the war effort.
It put steel in our spines. It made us cognizant of responsibility. It taught us, in my case, leadership. It taught us how futile war is. It taught us patriotism. It was a very valuable time in my life from a personal standpoint. And the country came together as a whole. It was unique. There were no people that were anti-war. I mean, everybody was willing to do what they could. We had sugar rationing. We had gas rationing.
Meat rationing.
Meat rationing, shoe rationing. You were only allowed to buy so many pairs of shoes. You were only allowed, every automobile had a sticker on it, an ABC sticker, depending on what you used the car for. And if you had an A sticker, you were allowed to buy, say, 6 gallons a week. If you had a B sticker, it was a lesser amount and so on. So we were conserving oil, we were conserving gasoline, and tires on the cars. They were rationed as well.
Well, they were using the rubber on those tires to put on the tanks and the...
The treads of the tanks. We took life at the age of 17, 18, and 19 so seriously. It was the we generation as opposed to the me generation.
We all did what we had to do. And we grew up. It was when we grew up, really.
I think that's probably summarizes it best of all. We grew up very quickly. At the age of 22, I was the navigator on a B-24 bomber. The lives of 11 men were my responsibility to get them there and get them home again.
You happened to have a very good pilot in addition.
But I told him where to go.
Okay.
And the crew was homogenous. We had an Arizona resident, one from Ohio, one from Chicago, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. So we learned all about the rest of the United States. We bonded together. No two of us on this 11-man crew came from the same background.
The greatest generation.
Yeah, Tom Brokaw put it best, the greatest generation.
A book that recommended reading to everybody. The men that are spoken about in the book, and in some cases they speak for themselves, they're Saul and they're me. And they came from the same backgrounds because we all lived through those days that were hellish. And we rose to become some things that we never dreamed we could be. We never dreamed we could achieve the things that we have. We didn't dare dream those dreams.
When I was overseas during World War II, we kept the bond weeks. We wrote letters to each other. We made plans. Of course, Hilda had a baby, and I didn't see my baby until she was 10 months old. We were rather rigid, rather strict as parents. We didn't allow the children to get away with too much.
I think that it had a lot to do with the way we were brought up. I think we realized that what we were doing was following in the tradition that our parents had taught us. And of course, there was much more that we could give our kids in material things than what we had gotten. But
let me say, at that point, there was a certain amount of guilt in the fact that we didn't have certain things growing up, and we wanted to give our children things that we didn't have as children.
Yes, that became the trend in our generation,
and
unfortunately.
We may have given them too much. We saw to it that our children went to work and gave us a certain amount of money that we put away for them.
They didn't know that.
And when they graduated high school, each one of them got a car. Now, we didn't have cars at that age, but, you know, we were determined to give our children everything.